Reimagining isn't just about rural. Reimagining is what you and I can do anywhere and everywhere. So we can start from where we are today, not necessarily in the rural domain. It is possible because India already has a platform which is 4G enabled, and it is in the hands of ordinary people like you, me, and 215 million people outside this room on Jio alone. So I thought I will tell you about the transformation that is possible from a slate batti, which all of us are familiar with, and what is happening already, where smartphones, smart devices, and feature devices are in the hands of this little child sitting inside a rural context, because something that is right at the back, the tower. So 6 months back, folks from Tadoba, which is a forest just next to Nagpur, about 40 kilometers away, hosted me for a tiger safari. A lot of us go for tiger safaris, and then we come back after a few photographs, and that's the end of it. Typically, people ask, "Kuch dikha? Did you see anything?" And that's about it. But these guys are persistent, so they followed up. And they said that each time in Tadoba, a matkasur, which is a large tiger in that place, has made a small kill in the village and the hamlets of Tadoba, which are located right inside the forest, we don't know how to call an ambulance. We have to take the patient either in the state they are in, or we have to wait endlessly before the closure with a doctor can happen. Likewise, when there are students who are told by the Mofassil school that they can download an e-book if they don't have the money to buy a textbook or even reach out to it in the distant town of Chandrapur, they don't know what to do. It struck me that a simple solution, which is to have a tower there, could have ameliorated the situation of these children, these patients, or for that matter, even banking, because banks also put ATMs at a place where there is network. So, getting back to the actual situation where the child and the slate batti is now linked to a smart device and a tower, we thought, can there be a way in which these 1,000 people located inside the heart of the jungle in Tadoba can get something more? They wrote to the chairperson of Reliance Foundation, and that was a letter with 700 thumbprints. 700 thumbprints saying, give us a tower and see us rise and shine. So, next. So then this boy, who is a conservationist, he's himself a TEDx Gateway alumna, he anchored this process. He reimagined sitting where he did in Tadoba, though he's a Bombay boy who has shifted, called Hans Dalal. He issued a video and this letter seeking help to actually get a tower up and energized in the forests of Tadoba. And today, children are able to download e-books. Doctors are able to either remotely or physically reach a lot faster. So can ambulances, and so can the banking network, which is a little more accessible than before. And I dare say, those of you worrying whether the safety of tigers is being compromised by the availability of phones, well, that's not the case. Actually, poaching incidents or even attempts have come down because anybody who is going in the forest is able to quickly reach out to the range forest officer and say that there is something happening which I am suspicious about, and that's about it. So it's the power of an idea that is everywhere. It's the power of reimagining what we can do sitting anywhere, anytime. I can go on to other examples where network and the platform that is available to us Indians, which actually adds up to the total usage in India on Jio alone, is 240 crore gigabytes per month. 240 crore gigabytes per month, ladies and gentlemen, is more than the accumulated usage of data in the entire United States. 240 crore gigabytes of data per month is more than the cumulative usage of data in the entire mainland of China as well. So that is the sort of change that is happening in the last about a year and a half in India, month on month, and that is not limited to data being used by rich and enabled people, but by those who you know in your daily life are creating the edifice and the backbone of Indian society, the farmer, the fisherman in this example, who is using GPRS-enabled devices to actually be safer and be more productive. Next. We can go into other examples, say for instance, this girl, Priyanka, who used the helpline number, the toll-free numbers, which are available aplenty and exponentially so, day on day, month on month in the Indian landscape, to actually connect with what she thought was her true calling in life. Priyanka, sitting as she did in the village that she did of Dundi Sarai, was able to reimagine, and she could reimagine everywhere. She could reimagine anywhere. Next. We could go on to Nudi Golappa, educated about the suitable use of fertilizers. I mean, fairly close to the heart of what really IRMA would probably be doing with its students and its faculty and its research. But being able to get the right advice, being able to get it online, being able to get it at dirt cheap prices is what India is now able to afford to its citizens. Next. Finally, this thing about something very close to all of us here, and I am particularly privileged to be standing here talking about reimagining everywhere, anywhere, on the anniversary of Padma Bhushan V. Kurian Saab. The fact that this farmer is able to reach the optimal volume of milk, one Mr. Nayak, and there are hundreds and thousands of Mr. Nayaks now, potentially that can connect with your knowledge, your IP, your video, your toll-free, and enhance the India story, enhance the Indian GDP. So, by and large, my proposition is therefore that reimagining, ladies and gentlemen, is possible in a myriad of ways, in a manner that we had not imagined a few years back, because there we could blame or we could apportion the responsibility on many other people, on governments, on institutions and therein. But today, because of ubiquitous 4G platforms that are available to India in a manner that don't exist even in the United States, because we have as much as 93% of our total telecom density is on mobile network, unlike in the US, which is about 45-55. So with 93% of our mobility driving this tirade of entrepreneurship, innovation, it is ultimately about people like you and me to not just reimagine rural, but reimagine anywhere and everywhere.